Hello everyone, I'm super excited to be here at India's first large-scale Vue conference. Let's start by taking a look at the current state of the Vue ecosystem, its community aspects, and some of the recent technical developments. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the Vue. So a brief history, Vue was created by Evan Yu. He was working for Google in AngularJS for a number of projects. So in his own words, he figured, what if we could just extract the part that he really liked about Angular and build something really lightweight on top of it? And voila, Vue was born. So Vue is a JavaScript framework. Yes, it's also progressive in nature. So if you're building user interfaces, it proves to be a great choice. And you don't have to take our word for it. If you go anywhere in the community, you just go ahead, give it a try. You'll always hear positive things about Vue. And by design, it's very easy to pick up, and this comes with contrast to other monolithic frameworks where typically you would have to do a full migration. So as we'll see in the upcoming talks today, Vue is not just suited for quick prototyping, it's perfectly capable of powering large-scale applications as well. So what's the buzz around Vue.js anyway? In mid-2018, Vue became the most starred JavaScript framework on GitHub. And earlier this year, Vue became the second most starred project on GitHub, that is across all languages. And that's just only behind Free Code Camp. So, booyah. Now, I'm not saying that more GitHub stars equals more usage. It's just that Vue is no longer the new kid on the block and is definitely worth checking. Let's see some of the adoption numbers. Vue has over 1 million weekly downloads on NPM. And not only that, it has more than 900,000 weekly active DevTools users. So DevTools is a browser extension which helps you in debugging. So this number really represents the large group of the developer community. And from my point of view, pun intended, this is more significant than the first number. Because the NPM downloads can include a variety of use cases, right? It can include downloads from automated CI builds, robots download some packages for their analysis purposes, etc. But DevTools provide a leading indicator of what's going to come. So these 900,000 users are using Vue in their day-to-day development work. And a significant number of them are going to write more of their future applications in Vue. Now, these are the number of hits on the JS Deliver CDN. So if you see the 10th place, Vue has over 900 million hits in the last 30 days. That's more than 30 million hits a day. That's pretty huge, right? And if you compare it with the NPM downloads number, this is way, way higher. And that is because Vue provides a drop-in solution as well. You could just add the CDN file, the script tag, and in any application, HTML web application, you're ready to use the power of Vue. Now, the two other numbers to note here are the jQuery and Bootstrap numbers, the 7th and the 8th places here. And if you compare the numbers, that's pretty close, don't you think? So, okay, no more numbers now. Let's move on to something real. Who uses Vue anyway? So for starters, Laravel is the one who started Vue's adoption. Then we have GitLab, who was again one of the early adopters of Vue. Behance uses Vue, Apple is using Vue, and the list goes on and on. Now, one of the other frequently asked questions is that, is anyone using Vue in India? Yes, the answer is yes. We have started seeing adoption in India, and some of the companies using Vue are Ola, Your Story, Zoomcar, SoulStore, and many more. So the key point I'm trying to make here is that Vue is now already being used by many of your peers. And this makes the case, if you're considering moving to Vue, this makes the case for using Vue in your organization a lot easier. But does it have an active community? So I'm proud to say that Vue Bangalore's community is now 2 years old, with over 900 members. You can find the link at bela.vue.community. Like, I'm hoping we hit the 1,000 member mark by the end of today. And we host regular monthly meetups covering a variety of topics. And more importantly, this means that if you face any problem in your day-to-day development, you have people you can reach out to for help. And that's pretty powerful. And other cities like Hyderabad, Delhi, and Pune are following suit and have growing communities. Future looks bright. Let's move on to the technical side. So Macros is the code name of the latest release of Vue, which is version 2.6. And there's an interesting naming convention here. So every big release is named after an anime with the X letter of the alphabet. So like in the past, we have had Ghost in the Shell and Dragon Ball as well. So you're welcome to place a bet on what the next one might be. And if you're just getting bored someday, you could just, if you want a curated selection of anime to binge watch, just open the releases and go through them. So let's see what it brings. One of the most important things that was released in Vue 2.6 is the new slot syntax. We had an RFC for it, and we'll talk more about it in a bit. It also comes with an improved asynchronous error handling. So if you are using async functions in your lifecycle hooks, the errors during those processes will now be captured by Vue's error handlers now. And you'll also be able to send these numbers to, like, you can handle them, you can monitor them, you can maybe send these numbers to Sentry, do anything. This release also improves the compiler error messages. So now, if you're making any syntax error in your template, Vue actually points you to the code frame where you have made the mistake. And an important point worth highlighting here is that this feature was contributed by a community member. Finally, we have the built-in data prefetch support during server-side rendering. And this is pretty important for solutions because up until now, there was a restriction that you can only place your data fetching logic in the top-level route component or in the specific component. Otherwise, that will be skipped. And in Vue 2.6, we have removed that. You can place your logic anywhere in your component tree. And this also allows higher order solutions like Nuxt to leverage this to simplify their implementation and make things easier for you. So overall, it will result in a better development experience for anyone using server-side rendering in your applications. So we talked about RFC. What's an RFC? RFC is a request for comments process. This is a framework for proposing changes in Vue. So you can just look, for beginners, this is a way to get involved with the community. You can go visit this link on GitHub and propose any ideas you have on how to improve Vue. There are open proposals as well where you can participate in discussions and contribute. So this makes things open in the sense that now you have an opportunity to voice your opinion. If the code team, let's say, misses an edge case, you can point it out. And from now on, all of the breaking changes go through RFCs. So it's a very good place to keep an eye on. Now, let's take a look at some of the recent RFCs. So the new slot syntax that was introduced in 2.6. So let's see what it brings. So for scope slots, it brings a more clear syntax. And we'll see some examples on what that means. And when you're using name slots, this brings a more uniform experience. That's also in line with improving DX or development experience. So let's see some examples on how this unification looks like. So this is how, the first code block shows how we used to define a default slot with text before, and the bottom one shows the new proposal. So when you even wanted to just pass a text in a slot, you would have had to wrap it inside a template attribute, and then you would have named it. You are passing the props. And now with the introduction of vslot directive, you can just bypass that altogether. You can just add that vslot directive on the Vue component itself, and this makes things easier. Now, if you don't have text, if you have an element inside, so here this is an example where the message is rendered inside a div. So this also makes like similar to the previous one, where you just put the directive on the component, and using the template syntax, the prop gets rendered inside the div attribute. And here's an example of name slots. So notice how we have had to define two attributes, one slot equal to one defines the name and the slot scope. This is now replaced by vslot colon the slot name. And this is where I was talking about the unification and more consistent experience. Everything else is the same. Now let's move on to another RFC. This is a bit of a controversial one, because this has made some headlines recently, and some even called it Vue's darkest day. So let's see what happened. So this is an example of a component where the logic is you have a count variable, you have a double variable which is supposed to store the count into two, and you have a button where on click it has to increment the count variable by one. And this is how we are used to writing the script right now. We export it in a data variable, we write the method increment, and we add a computed property double. This is what was proposed. You define three constants, count, double, and increment, and you just return everything. And the initial reaction, including mine, was this is quite complicated. And it goes against the principle of the whole point of Vue is it's simple. And this is not simple. And the best part about RFCs is that they are not set in stone. So we had a lot of discussions, and there were some modifications made, and there are some key things which I want to clear. This change is purely additive to 2.x. It doesn't break anything. You don't have to rewrite anything if you don't want to. Just keep using Vue the way you are being using. And there's no plan of deprecating the object API right now. It stays for the foreseeable future. And here is the revised RFC. So note how the Vue had taken suggestions from the community and discarded the previous RFC. And this is the revised RFC. And it makes things simpler by retaining the benefits of logic reuse and better type inference. And this is the RFC that was closed, where you have everything count, double, and increment different. And this is the new proposed RFC. It was opened quite recently, 2 weeks back. And to emphasize again, this is an open state, and you can join the discussion on GitHub right now. So this is more in line with the current syntax, where you have a state object which includes everything, your data and computer variable, you have a function, and you return that. So let's quickly take a look at some of the other things. Everyone needs a mobile app nowadays. So for building those, we have solutions like TypeScript, Vue, and Weeks. And we are also maturing Cordova-based solutions like Kassar, Ionic 4, and Onsen UI. Kassar recently released a 1.0 version earlier, sometime this year, and it's really impressive. You should check it out. Quickly moving on to server-side rendering. It's been on the rise in recent years, and happily so, because of the benefits it provides, better SEO, and faster time to content. And the Vue ecosystem is also sorted on SSR. Next, and the pre-render SPU plugin are the most popular choices for achieving this. So coming to sustainability, as GitHub stars don't pay the bills. And the major one of the major differences which makes Vue stand out is that it's not backed by any corporate. So, but the challenge that comes with this is that of sustainability on, like, how do we get people to continue working on this while making sure the quality is not compromised. So even has a Patreon to fund his full-time work on Vue, and there's also an open collective which is backed by the community, which fund the work by other cool team members. So in terms of sustainability, I would say Vue is in pretty good shape and it's going to stay. So to summarize, Vue is getting more popular day by day and has started gaining adoption. People around Vue are either already using Vue or learning Vue. The latest release of 2.6 has brought some performance improvements as well. Vue is flexible. Now, this is an important point. So the flexibility is in the sense that it doesn't force you to use any particular template syntax or even TypeScript. Like, you can just use plugin stylus if you don't like closing HTML tags. It's very flexible in that. The mobile ecosystem is quite mature now and is ready to take on your requirements. Plus, it's sustainable. So it's here to stay for a long time. And Vue 3 is coming. So despite what you may have heard, it doesn't force you to use TypeScript. It's your choice, as developer experience has always been of utmost importance in Vue's books. And today's closing talk will go into more details about it, so stay tuned. And that's all from my side. My name is Swapnil, and you can find me at swapnil.net. Thanks everyone for being here, and have a beautiful day.